Web Accessibility Matters with David Berman. Difficulties and technologies, avoiding trade-offs. Image of a computer keyboard with wheelchair symbol on one of the keys. David Berman appears on screen and faces the camera for the duration of this video. David is wearing a dark gray suit with a black shirt and tie.
The best way to get the best results from web accessibility is to understand the type of difficulties that people are grappling with and the kind of technologies we use to mitigate those challenges. And so my plan now is we're going to walk through the type of difficulties people encounter. I've found that we can create an accessible website without trade-offs. You see, often people think, oh, if I make my website accessible, I'm going to have to make the experience worse for my typical users. And that could be true if you don't understand why or how we're doing this. But if you truly understand the difficulties and the type of technologies we're using to overcome them, then it's possible to create an accessible site, accessible product that has no trade-offs at all. In fact, chances are we're going to make things better for everyone, because when we design for the extremes, everyone benefits. When we think of the type of challenges people are dealing with, I find it useful to consider disabilities in categories. The first one being permanent disabilities. We tend to think about the permanent disabilities first. Someone who's blind since birth and may never see at all in their lifetime, or someone who can't hear at all and may never hear. But in fact, the vast majority of difficulties and challenges are more subtle and temporary. Temporary disabilities include everything from maybe you've just been to the eye doctor and there's drops in your eyes, or maybe you've got the flu, or maybe you're pregnant, or maybe you're drunk. These are all things that come and go. You may have a post-traumatic stress disorder where at times of day you don't have your typical cognitive faculties. And we need to consider the whole breadth of disability when we're designing the truly accessible products. We also have acquired disability. As we age, our eyesight tends to go. We tend to have more mobility challenges as we get older as well. You know, the typical life expectancy of a man in the Middle Ages in Europe was perhaps 36 years old. And yet all of us plan to live much longer than that. And so these acquired challenges are important as well. And then finally, we have societal challenges as well. We have things that shouldn't be a disability at all, perhaps like being left-handed. This also can be a challenge in some parts of the world. Now, when we think of the different types of impairments people are challenged with, it's useful to simply think of the different human senses. And I'm going to march through the human senses and look at challenges in each area in the order that they tend to be the biggest challenge for us on the web. The most common type of difficulty we tend to dwell on is the visual challenge, people's having problems seeing. And it makes sense, because for most of us, the largest bandwidth pipe for information coming into the human brain is the eye. And whether someone has an extreme situation where they can't see at all, or perhaps they see fine but they don't see certain frequencies of light, so certain colors are left out for them. Perhaps they have a constraint on their vision. We have a whole host of assistive technologies, which I'll get into more deeply later, which helps balance off this challenge of not being able to see. The second group of challenges most prevalent when we're designing products online are dexterity or mobility challenges. And again, this can be of a range from the extreme of perhaps someone is a quadriplegic, has no use of their limbs from the neck down. Or it could be as subtle as someone who has complete use of all of their limbs, but it hurts to move in certain ways, and so they prefer not to. And so from those two extremes, we have a continuum of mobility challenges, and we have, again, a great range of assistive technologies that help us mitigate for mobility challenges. The third group of assistive technologies range around hearing difficulties, and again, there's a range. Some people just got a little too close to the left speaker in a Genesis concert younger in life and don't hear so well in one ear than the other. Others maybe don't hear at all. Some people can't hear certain frequencies, and in fact we find in the acquired category, as we get older, there are certain frequencies which simply drop off completely. Again, we have technologies which overcome this. Now, your web product, your website may have a lot of sound, or it may have none at all. But if you do have audio content, we have a variety of techniques to help overcome the challenge that some people either all the time or some of the time can't hear. The fourth group are language and speech difficulties. And there's quite a range of challenges here. It could be simply someone didn't learn how to speak the language of your sight early in life. And you know, we humans were designed to acquire language at the age of 3 or 4. So if someone acquired, let's say, English or French later in life, it's not never going to be as natural as if they learned it as an infant. As well, some people are just wired differently. For some people, language comes in a different way. For some, they experience language in the typical way, but the way it comes out, the way they express themselves is very different. And so we have quite a range of technologies which can also help mitigate for language and speech problems. Kind of a sibling to this are cognitive and learning challenges, and there's quite a range here as well, everything from an extreme dyslexia, from simply subtle challenges of being able to remember certain facts. One of the really big challenges we have with cognitive difficulties is that they can be quite subtle and not present apparently. For instance, if someone has a severe visual challenge, they may arrive with a service dog or a white cane. It'll be apparent to you fairly quickly that they don't see, or they don't see that well. However, with cognitive challenges, usually they're not readily apparent. In fact, the person who has the cognitive challenge may not even know themselves that they have them. You know, we do work at Carleton University, and we find that the students we help with disabilities, over 80% of the kids we're helping out are those with cognitive challenges. So, again, we have a variety of technologies that can help overcome learning disabilities. In fact, I'm convinced we all have dyslexia to a certain degree and attention deficit disorder to a certain degree.
David is holding a small toy tiger he will use to demonstrate the positional limitations of the alphabet.
We do something to the kids in our society which is rather tricky. You know, consider this. If you meet a tiger in the wild and, you know, this is a tiger, and if I rotate it, it's still a tiger, and this is a tiger, and this is a tiger. That's the reality of living in the forest. And yet we teach our children an alphabet where if you take the letter, a lowercase b, and you rotate it, it becomes something completely different, a d, and then you flip it downward, it becomes a lowercase b. You flip it again and it's a lowercase q. This type of symbols, it's brilliant, but you know, we're running on 50,000 year old hardware, and yet the idea of written language is only perhaps 6-7,000 years old. We all struggle then with symbols that change their meaning as we move them around. It's just those that struggle enough with it that it falls outside the norm, we have a label for that. The last group of difficulties are ones we invent, as if we don't have enough already in our society. Some parts of the planet are still very harsh on people who try to write with their left hand as children rather than their right. And we stigmatize some disabilities. We make it difficult to be honest with each other about the challenges we have. And it really depends, and we're getting better and better at this. You know, a lot of people I know wear glasses. And you don't tend to think of glasses as an assistive technology. But I'm sure the first time someone wandered out into the streets in 17th century Europe with lenses strapped to their face, people must have pointed and said, that guy's crazy. And yet today we feel completely comfortable letting others know that we don't see so well. And yet for other disabilities, we're not quite there. And this is part of the challenge of society. We're quickly evolving to be more caring and more accepting of our differences. And when we accept our differences and recognize them, only then are we able to do the best job we can of communicating with everyone and leaving no one behind.
Appointed a high-level advisor to the UN, David Berman has traveled to over 50 countries, inspiring professionals on how we can design a better civilization. Rated number one in North America as a speaker on accessibility, he's presented at the largest design conferences on 4 continents. David has audited websites of 40 countries for the World Wide Web Foundation. His book, Do Good Design, is published in 5 languages.
Expert speaker David Berman. Links to resources mentioned can be found at www.davidberman.com/accessibility/resources. Produced by David Berman Communications. Production credits, Ben Armitage, Jennifer Beharry, Veronica File, Simone Flanagan, Cynthia Hoffos, Stephen Kimball, Macha Kozlowski, Khadija Safri, Justin Stratton. Copyright 2014, David Berman Communications. Learning guides, coaching, and on-site courses are available on WCAG 2.0, the new standard on accessibility, accessible PDF by design, accessible apps, mobile touch, accessible e-learning, perfecting your web strategy 2.0, slide shows cover of various learning guides. To purchase learning guides, visit davidberman.com/store. To learn more, visit David's blog at davidberman.com/blog. Image of David Berman's book, Do Good Design, available at www.davidberman.com/dogoodgooglebook. Contact us for accessibility workshops, webinars, audits, remediation, and certification at facebook.com/davidbermancommunications. On twitter.com/davidberman. Or call us at 1-613-728-6777.